Hey, my name is Matt Johnson. Today I'm going to be showing you how to easily edit and export high quality videos for YouTube Shorts in Adobe Premiere Pro. To save you time though, if you don't want to watch me ramble through this whole video, you can click the link right down in the description to download my YouTube Shorts export presets completely for free and start exporting immediately. Also down below, you will find a link to this video's sponsor, MATTMUSICBED, but more on them in a bit. Alternatively, if you want to see the entire exporting process, keep watching. Welcome to Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, I've already imported some footage from a trip to New York City that I filmed recently, and the first thing that you're going to notice is that this is a horizontal 16:9 video. But wait, Matt, YouTube Shorts are vertical. Yes, we need to make a new sequence and modify this video to fit the vertical YouTube Shorts format. To make a new sequence with the project panel highlighted in blue down here, you can either press Control N on PC or Command N on Mac, or you can go up here to File, New Sequence, and that's gonna open up the new sequence dialog box. Here you're gonna wanna click Digital SLR, 1080p, DSLR 1080p 24, and go up here to Settings. For your time base, by default, the vast majority of cameras are filming at 23.976 frames per second. If you want to export your video at a different frame rate, say 30 FPS or 60 FPS, you can choose that here. But for most people, you're gonna wanna leave it at 23.976. Now, where we need to make a change though is under frame size. So instead of this being 1920 by 1080, we need to make this 1080 by 1920. Yeah, we're flipping things around here, baby. All of the rest of these settings are good by default. Go down here to Save Preset, and let's call this YouTube Short - Who is Matt? There you go, press OK. And then all you have to do is go down here to the bottom under Custom, and you will find the YouTube Short preset. Now let's call this sequence YouTube Short. There you go, just for the demo, who cares? Press OK, and that's gonna make a new sequence. We can then select this video footage that I filmed, drag it over here to the timeline, make sure you click Keep Existing Settings wherever you do this, and wait a second, it's all squished in the middle. Dang it, we gotta resize this thing so it fits properly. So to resize your video clip, you're gonna go up here to the Effect Controls, and then under Scale, you can scale this clip up. And I find for YouTube Shorts, about 316 scaling for a 4K horizontal video clip looks good. Then you can use the Position tool here to drag right and left to position your video clip so it looks good. In this case, I want it right here in the middle. That looks great. And lastly, this video clip is too long. Keep in mind that YouTube Shorts are a maximum of 60 seconds right now at the time of making this video. So let's drag this back down here so it's shorter. And now we've got our video properly sized and we're ready to export it. To export your video with this timeline selected and highlighted in blue, you can either press Control M on PC, Command M on Mac, or go up here to File, Export Media. Welcome to the export settings page now for file name. I'm gonna leave this title YouTube Short, but you can change this to title your video whatever you want. For location, this is very important because you need to click on this and select where you want your video file to be saved. With that location selected, click Save. And then for format, you're gonna wanna select H.264, and then your preset is gonna be set to whatever the last preset that you use for Premiere Pro is. But in your case, we're gonna wanna customize this. So leave it to whatever it's set to here and go down here to the video dropdown. And then here under basic video settings, click match source. And that is going to automatically resize things to the sequence settings that we made. So now suddenly your frame size should say custom 1080 by 1920. If it doesn't, you can click this checkbox. Click this drop down here and resize things properly. Click that checkbox again. Frame rate 23.976, field order progressive, aspect square, that looks great. We need to click more though. Oh yeah, there's more settings hidden down here. We ain't done yet. Make sure that render maximum depth and use maximum render quality is checked because we want the maximum quality. Duh, of course we do. And then here for performance under encoding settings, make sure this is set to hardware encoding if you can, which is gonna help your computer render it out faster. If you have to choose software encoding, that's okay too. All of these settings here are good. Main, 4.1, Rec 709, 100. And then we're gonna scroll down here to bitrate settings. And this is where things are really important. By default, Premiere is probably gonna be set to VBR 2 pass, but you're gonna wanna set this to CBR, which stands for constant bitrate, which means that basically you're gonna be telling Premiere to throw as much video data as you can at this footage, which is going to help increase the quality, especially once YouTube compresses it. For your target bitrate, you're gonna wanna set this to 40 megabits per second. And I know this is very high, but keep in mind that YouTube is gonna process this video and compress it smaller, and you want a high bitrate so you don't have compression artifacts. Then down here, let's click the audio drop-down menu. For audio, choose AAC, AAC for the audio codec, 48,000 hertz, channel stereo. And then for bitrate, you're gonna wanna click down here and bring it all the way down to 512, because we can do 512 now. Why not have higher audio quality? It's not gonna make the file size much bigger. Go for it. Lastly, let's save these settings as a preset so you don't have to resave them again and again. So up here under preset, click these three dots here, and then click save preset, and let's call this YouTube Shorts 1080 x1920 23.976 FPS, 40 Mbps CBR, who is Matt. This way you can see all of your settings at a glance and then press OK. And now anytime you want to export using these settings, you can simply click the drop down here and select that preset. Lastly, all you need to do is go down here in the bottom right and click export if you want to export in Premiere Pro, or you can click send to media encoder if you want to export from media encoder, which will enable you to be able to continue editing in the background. In media encoder, all you have to do is go over here and click the green play button, which will start your video rendering. And then once your video is rendered, you need to upload it. And you can use a site like Dropbox, which you can sign up for down below, or use AirDrop if you're on a Mac. Then use your phone and the Dropbox app or AirDrop to save the video to your phone. Open the YouTube app and then upload your short there and hit post. With that, you now know how to upload high quality videos to YouTube Shorts using Adobe Premiere Pro. If you haven't downloaded the preset for exporting to YouTube Shorts, it's still linked down below in the description. Also linked down below is a link to this video's sponsor, MusicBed. MusicBed is my favorite place to find music for my projects. And with over 1,000 artists and over 40,000 songs, I can always find the right one. They've got bands like Tall Heights with the most incredible folk sound. Heartfelt songs from singer-songwriters like Mackenzie Lockhart. And the most incredible soul music from artists like Jake Isaac. Plus, MusicBed's search tools make it easy to find music with filters that let you search by BPM and key, not to mention playlists from your favorite filmmakers. I personally love the funky and folk pop playlists and spend a pretty good amount of time in there when I'm looking for inspiration. My secret weapon, though, is MusicBed's complimentary song search service, where they will help you find the exact song that you need for your video. This can help you save so much time. So take your projects and films to the next level with MusicBed. You can hear the difference their music makes for yourself by signing up for a free account. And when you're ready to sign up, you can use the coupon code MATTMUSICBED, all caps, all one word when checking out, to get 1 month free with the purchase of an annual subscription. Thanks again to MusicBed for sponsoring this video. It would also be a huge help to me if you would consider liking this video and subscribing if you want to see more tutorials like it in the future. Please also comment down below and let me know what other videos you want to see from me. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.